Hi, I'm James from Sugru, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to rebuild missing bumpers from your toilet seat so that you don't have to live with this horrible, rattling, noisy crap anymore. And Sugru is perfect for this project because it will bond to the toilet seat, allow you to build a bumper at whatever size you want, and because it's rubber, it has really good dampening properties, so it should be nice and quiet when it's finished. Fix the toilet. For this tutorial, you will need a pair of scissors, toilet paper, it'll make sense later, and I'm using 2 mini packs of Sugru, 1 black and 1 white, because I want a color match to match this one, but also this is a very large bumper, so I need this much. Okay, let's get started. First off, just cut open your mini pack, follow the dotted lines, peel open the foil, and pop out your Sugru. So I have a 5 gram of black and white Sugru here. To make a light gray, I'm going to add a very small amount of the black. It's easier to start light and make the color darker than mixing it too dark from the start. So just press the Sugru together and knead it in your fingers until the color is thorough. Okay, this already seems fairly dark. Yeah, it's close. I think it's pretty close.
Acoustically, it's really quite interesting down here.
You will find that your fingers get sticky mixing Sugru, and that's what the toilet paper is for. It's perfect for wiping Sugru from your fingers, and it means that it won't stick to you so much as you continue. Okay, next up, actually, a really good tip. There's 2 large holes here that need to be filled in this particular project. So I'm going to use my black Sugru to fill those so I don't use up my color mixed gray. So press a lump in each of those. I'm now ready to build up the bumper with my gray Sugru. So it's quite simple. Just press the Sugru into the middle of where you want to position the bumper and spread it out to the size you want it to be. The best way to do this is just gently, repeatedly pressing. When you start this, it's just gonna look like a complete mess. And don't worry, it just takes about 2 minutes of careful pressing to get it to look really good. I don't know what to say here, it's just about spending a little bit of time. Okay, a really good tip for getting a lovely finish on Sugru is to gently roll your finger over the surface. It's better than squeezing or pressing, it just gives you a much nicer finish. And just keep gently touching it until you get a shape you're really happy with. Another good tip for keeping making the edges look tidy is just to rub your finger around it like this. That's not nice. So that's pretty much formed. The final step on this project is to level the toilet seat. Level the toilet seat.
Level it!
And it's quite a simple thing to do. You just press it down and get it level. But to prevent the Sugru from sticking to the ceramic, use soapy water. I should have mentioned this earlier. I totally forgot. Forgive me.
So just dip your finger in soapy water, rub it on the surface of the Sugru, and then lower the seat onto the toilet and level it, and then lift it off. Okay, so you finished this hack, and all you have to do is leave it to cure overnight. Actually, leave this one to cure for 24 hours because there's a lot of weight applied to this, so you need to give it a full 24 hours to allow the Sugru to cure. So there's 2 tips for this. One is you can take the toilet seat in its up position so you don't pull it down, or you can create a roll of cardboard and tape it to the toilet seat. Okay, I'll be back in 24 hours.
Okay, so 24 hours later, Sugru is fully cured to a tough silicone rubber and works a treat, so it's lovely, balanced and quiet and protected again. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to check out sugru.com for more tips, projects and stuff you'll probably find useful. If you try this out or have any challenges for us, let us know. We'll give it a whirl. Keep fixing.